8210. You'd have been able to press 228 and then original Super Mario Land. Well, hello, my darlings. I've got a bit of a different video today. I've been clearing out my house and I kept finding old gadgets from the past. Some of them are really quite vintage and I wanted to show some of them to you. I'll just show you quickly what we've got to start with. These are not that old. We have an old digital camera, like a photography camera, and then an old video camera. Oh, ah, she's awake. These, I'm guessing, are from about 2010. I'll show you them a bit more. Then I found... This is a Nintendo DS. I don't know exactly when it's from. I think it must be around 2005. This is still working. We're going back in time chronologically. DS. Okay, then. Who remembers these? This is an iPod Classic. It's not the first release of iPod. There was one before it, I believe, which had four buttons across here. But this guy must be from about 2004. Okay. I know this doesn't look real. I promise you. This is a real phone. This was my phone. This is a Nokia 8210. And I think this is from about the year 2000. Then, a Game Boy Color. I had an older one of these, the first release of Game Boy, which was grey and it was bigger. However, I remember the screen broke, so I guess I chucked it away at some point. But this was released in 1998. And then, look at this. I think this is from around the same time, around 1998. A Nokia, what is it? Nokia 5110. Oh, wow. This doesn't work. I've tried charging it. Plug it in to charge it. I still have the wire for charging it, but it's been charging for a while and nothing's happening. I think it also came with something I could sit this in to charge it, but memory card. I forgot that was in there. There's probably some photos on there still. I don't know when this is from. It must be a similar sort of time to this. I'm guessing about 2010. Everyone's phone had a camera on. This was a very common sight to see. You would take it on holiday with you. You would take it for just an evening out with friends. And the photos are still digital, so you'd end up taking quite a lot of photos still, just like people do now. to see still had some old videos. Oh, it wants me to do the settings. And I can... This is actually a touch screen, which was pretty fancy at the time. You had to have one of these if you wanted to capture any video footage of anything. Some digital cameras had a video function, but they weren't very good. So again, a lot of families had these. And again, it's digital recordings. And you'd see dads holding cameras like this, recording the school nativity play. Very common sight. And I think there is videographers sometimes like to get their hands on older cameras, probably older than this, but there is a retro feel that comes with a camera recording like this, even though it was digital. It's something that you can't really fake with a modern day camera. Okay, let's do the DS next. I think this is from around 2005. And it is complete with classic Super Mario. And so we still have the stylus, which I never used to like. Please come to life. I've been charging it. Shame. Okay. Oh my gosh, that sound. It's a shame. I can't play it. I'm gutted, I can't play it. One of the earlier handheld games consoles, not the earliest, but one of the early ones. And then this absolute marvel. I'm so glad I kept this. I don't have a charger for it anymore. I'm sure I could buy one on Amazon. I would really like to see what music's on here. And I do still have a headphone with an old headphones jack like that. So maybe one day I'll just order the charger. Can you remember the really satisfying kind of ticking sound it would make? Because this wheel was touch screen, it was touch sensitive, and so you would scroll by doing this. I wish it was working and I could show you. And everyone just thought it was so cool that you could store weeks worth of music on here, as if anyone ever needed. It's 20 gigabytes. You're probably just going to get a reflection. Very scratched up. I took this on holiday with me quite a lot. It went everywhere with me. And I used it for years. Even after people had other ways of playing music, I kept this going. I just really liked it. I still really like it. Next, the phone that looks like a toy. I promise you, this is a real phone. It's got a different cover. In the day when you could buy phone covers, and every teenager for their birthday would get an assortment of phone covers. This is a Nokia 8210 from around 2000, the turn of the millennium. This was my phone, and I loved it back in the day when mobile phones were getting smaller and smaller. I would say this is one of the smallest ones that Nokia made. It was red, the original cover on it was red. You could get it in red or blue. I'm going to take the cover off to show you the inside to prove that it's a real phone, because my children don't believe this is a real phone. The charger is long gone. Back when Nokias would charge with this sort of input. So there. That's the inside to show that it is real. These keys were pretty hard to press, being so tiny and not being isolated buttons, but I managed okay. I mean, I probably had pretty small hands. And the back. Got no SIM card in. Why this has survived in my drawers for so long, I don't know. Okay, these next two I think are from around the same time, but one of them just just looks so much older. I'm going to save the Nokia till the end. Game Boy Color, I think, is around 1998. And this, my friends, is going strong. I still play on this. So it has a color game in, but all my favorite games were fun from the original Game Boy. You could play the same games from the original Game Boy. You could play them in the Game Boy Color, they just wouldn't be color. So this is Super Mario Deluxe for the color, which I will show you. But also, I have look at this. What are these cases? Super Mario Land. These games would have been released in more like 1992. So I will have got these games around 1992 for my original Game Boy. Actually, I'm going to put this one in because this is original and best. Gonna go. I can't see what I'm doing, so I'll go until I die. Oh, I'm gonna die. Oh, what a great game. Let's do Tetris. Oh my gosh. I'm not gonna play. Tetris. So again, this game will be from around 1992 for the original Game Boy. Mario, Donkey Kong Land, and I used to have this, which was the coolest thing ever, because it's a camera, and you could add effects, you could take a picture and then add effects, and the screen was so pixelated, it was so bad, but it was amazing because you didn't have any kind of digital camera back in those olden days. So this was very cool. I took it on a school trip once and everyone loved playing with it. Game Boy. This is the oldest one. This is a real fossil. This was my dad's mobile phone. And I believe it's a Nokia 5110. which would have been circa 1998. It's gone aerial. Sadly, it's not one of those ones you could pull up. This is the, as far as I'm concerned, the original phone where one can play Snake. Original Snake. Not where you, not the ones where you can go through the walls, like on the 3310. The 5110, you can't go through the walls on Snake. And if you got really good at it, you could play it just by using 1 and 9. And that's what I used to do. Again, I have no way of charging this. Probably something you could pick up on Amazon, a charger for this, but I don't need it. I actually kept a charger for a really long time because I used to enjoy playing Snake on this phone so much. I don't know where it is now. It's probably in my house, but so a very simple old mobile phone. You could call, you could text, and you could play games, and of course you could play with the ringtones. This is a real museum piece. So texting was quite different on a phone like this. Later on, predictive text became a thing, but it wasn't always a thing. And you used to have to type out every single letter. So a C would be pressing the 2 button 3 times. And then you would have to wait, because I want to write cat and I need the A. So you'd wait a moment. And then you'd press it once, and you'd have an A, and then T on 8. As things progressed with predictive texting, you could have been able to press 228, and then the phone would guess that you wanted to write cat. But I don't think this phone had that. It wasn't like today, where you could keep a phone and get the software updates, because these phones weren't linked to the internet in any way. So however the phone operated, that's how it operated for its entire life. So there we are, guys, that's our trip down memory lane for today. I'm trying to decide which is my favourite. Probably the iPod Classic or the Game Boy.